how ankylosing spondylitis happens. For ankylosing spondylitis to happen, two conditions need to be fulfilled. Condition one, the patient has an ankylosing spondylitis button in his body. Of course, this is not a literal button, of course. I'm using this as a model to explain it, and I will explain it more now. Condition two, someone presses or switches on the ankylosing spondylitis button. So what is the button, and what or who switches it on? Only those who have one of the buttons of ankylosing spondylitis might get the disease. Might get the disease means that they have one of the buttons of the disease and still not get the disease, simply because the button was never turned on. Those who do not have any of the buttons of ankylosing spondylitis will never, ever get the disease. So a patient might ask, what are those buttons of ankylosing spondylitis? Because if I know them, I will make sure I get rid of them to ensure I never get that disease. You cannot remove them. If you have any one of them, it's because you inherited it from your parents or grandparents. It's in your genes. In medical terms, what are those ankylosing spondylitis buttons? Now look at this. Look at those microbes. Those are microbes that might enter the body. Those arrows, HLA-B24, the brown one, then the green one, HLA-B25, then HLA-B26, 27, 28, and more. Each one of those arrows represents a normal molecule or component of the immune system that is supposed to carry out a normal function in attacking back if microbes try to attack our bodies. Because each one of them has a different code or number, this means that each one of them has somehow a unique or different way of doing its function in fighting microbes. There are many different HLA-Bs in this world, actually hundreds. Each one of us only inherits two HLA-Bs. To make it easier, there are many different eye colors in this world, likely 20 different eye colors in this world. Each one of us only inherits one eye color. Like those seven guys, like this guy has HLA B24 and 25. This lady has B26 and 27. The next is 29, 30, 28, 29, 33, 34, 25, 28, 30, 31, and so on. So each human being inherits, through his parents, only two HLA-Bs from the large list of possible options that exist in the human race. And also, just like the color of your eyes will always depend on the colors of the eyes that your parents have in their genes, which HLA-Bs you inherit will always depend on which HLA-Bs your parents have in their genes. How is all this related to our disease? How is all this related to ankylosing spondylitis? Well, this is it. Certain HLA-B molecules, those arrows that we've been presenting in the slides, certain HLA-Bs, while doing their normal function in attacking microbes, are famous for the possibility of getting confused and initiating an attack to certain parts of the body itself and not only to microbes. One such molecule is the HLA-B27. If you inherit the HLA-B27, this means that you have a molecule that, in addition to fighting microbes, which is its normal function in the immune system, might someday also initiate an attack by your immune system directed against the joints and ligaments of your neck and back, which is the disease we call ankylosing spondylitis. So the B27, it's a normal molecule in the human body. It's not a disease, it's just a normal molecule in the human body. It attacks back to microbes, but maybe sometimes it makes this mistake and result in initiating the process of ankylosing spondylitis. Remember, it's only a mite. So if you inherit the HLA-B27, this means you are susceptible only. You are susceptible to ankylosing spondylitis. You can consider this a button for the disease that, if pressed in a certain way, maybe nobody will ever press it, that if pressed in a certain way, might initiate the disease. HLA-B27 is the most famous button for ankylosing spondylitis. A blood test can tell you if you are HLA-B27 positive or negative. There are also other buttons, but are not routinely tested in the labs. Now, back to the eye colors example to explain another interesting fact about ankylosing spondylitis and the B27. If I tell you that those who have blue eyes are more likely to get a disease called eye melanoma, this means that melanoma will be more common in Europe or in Africa. Remember, if I tell you that those who have blue eyes are more likely to get a disease called eye melanoma, so you expect this disease to be more common in Europe or in Africa. Remember, Africa, very few people have blue eyes anyway. Europe, so many people have blue eyes, so probably it will be in Europe. More people, more patients with eye melanoma, you will find them in Europe than in Africa. And if I tell, likewise, if I tell you that those who have HLA-B27 are more likely to get a disease called ankylosing spondylitis, this means that ankylosing spondylitis will be more common in those regions of the world where more people have HLA-B27 than in those regions where people have where few people have HLA-B27. And this explains the notable geographical variations in the incidence of ankylosing spondylitis in different regions of the world. There's a region in on the west coast of North America. It's called Jeddah. The Jeddah people live there. 50% of the Jeddah people have HLA-B27, and they have the highest possible prevalence of ankylosing spondylitis all over the world. Like 6%, 6 out of every 100 persons have ankylosing spondylitis or might get ankylosing spondylitis there. Contrast this to somewhere in Europe, like in Greece, where only 5% of the population have B27, in contrast to 50% there in Jeddah. And here you get only 0.2% of the population might get, they are actually get ankylosing spondylitis. In the Middle East, in this part of the world, it seems from limited studies that HLA-B27 is not so prevalent. So we should expect to see less ankylosing spondylitis patients in the Middle East. However, this is not true. We see a lot of cases. Other disease buttons, it seems, are more important in this region, in our region. So, we mentioned at the beginning of this lecture, for ankylosing spondylitis to happen, two conditions need to be fulfilled. The patient has an ankylosing spondylitis button, we mentioned this already, and the second is the ankylosing spondylitis button is switched on. What or who presses the button in those persons who have the button? Probably certain types of infections. Smoking also helps, or we are not really sure. A clear suspect does not have to be there most of the time. Most probably it's an infection. An infection with one of several microbes like Shigella, Salmonella, Yersinia enterocolitica, those are the names if anybody's interested, one of those microbes might trigger the onset of the disease in the person who has inherited the HLA-B27 button or one of the other disease buttons. This is how ankylosing spondylitis happens, and this is how the process is initiated in patients who are susceptible to it.